And joining us also in this block is the former federal prosecutor and founder of Freedom Watch, Larry Klayman. Larry, there you are. Good to see you.
Good to see you too again.
And listen, you filed an interesting lawsuit, which I want to talk to you about, but I want to tie up some unfinished business first, Larry. I'm going to just ask you a real quick question about the Bundys. Are they all tied up, finished, and done? Do the Bundys and their family have to worry about any further harassment? And I use that term on purpose, from the feds?
I don't think they're worried, Bill, because they know that justice is on their side and God is on their side. I mean, it was basically a spiritual experience that we uncovered this massive prosecutorial misconduct, which got the indictment dismissed. And you can see it at freedomwatchusa.org or cliveandbundydefensefund.org. More information about that. But no, they're not done, because no sooner than the indictment was dismissed, these rabid leftist environmental groups started screaming, calling the Bundys racist. Of course, everybody's racist today. You, me, everybody, anybody that you don't agree with. And then demanding that the Bureau of Land Management go in and conduct another paramilitary raid on the property. So we are fighting that. I'm in Washington this week. I'll be meeting with congressmen who want to know what went on at the Bundy Ranch, this gross abuse of due process and everything else, Second Amendment rights, First Amendment rights. I'm trying to meet with the Justice Department, Attorney General Jeff Sessions. I'm trying to have the Bundys invited to the White House by the president, because the way they were treated is exactly the way the president's currently being treated by special counsel Robert Mueller and others. And as importantly, we're going to be filing a complaint for declaratory relief in the state court in Nevada to have the land declared land of the people of Nevada, which means that the federal government, even though they don't have any jurisdiction to begin with, will have a court rule that they should lay off the Bundys, go back to doing things that the federal government was intended to do under our Constitution. The government, federal government, does not have the right to own land except under certain limited circumstances, like military bases, veterans hospitals. They claim to own 85% of the land.
Yep.
In Nevada. Now, how can you be a state if you claim to own 85% of the land and you're the federal government?
Yeah, no, you know what? Go ahead, Dan. No,
well, just, Larry, if number one, how does BLM get away, or how do these environmentalists appeal to BLM on the basis of, quote, racism, unquote, to go after the Bundys yet again, number one? And number two, on what basis is the federal government claiming that 85% of the land in Nevada is under federal control?
Good question. There is no basis, but today everybody's a racist. You know, when Cliven, in effect, was acquitted with his sons last week, these environmental groups said, well, the only reason he was acquitted is because he's a white person. I mean, give me a break. With regard to the land, the land was only held by the federal government in trust for a short period of time, and it reverted to the states when they became states. And it's not just Nevada that has this issue, but Utah, Arizona, and the federal government even claims 38% of land in California, if you can believe that. So this is a non-starter. At the end of the Obama administration, Obama nationalized Cliven's ranch in a very vindictive act. He also nationalized large parts of Utah. And recently, President Trump denationalized large parts of Utah, and we're hoping that he'll do the same thing in Nevada. The president's been very sympathetic of the Bundys and their plights, as well as ranchers out the West.